greetings. I encourage you to watch Anwar and think about the errors and frauds you are taught to repeat. I had finished my apology to Anwar and began catching up on traffic. He continued to demand evidence from me while he refused to produce any evidence, specifically book and chapter and verse, supporting Sura 61 verse 6. This is not a hard demand to meet if Muhammad were honest. Anwar, show book and chapter and verse where Jesus said, I come to announce the seal of the prophets to come after me, named Muhammad. All it takes is a simple reply. Text, that comes from the Book of Blah, chapter 13, verses 9 through 11. I'll open my Bible to the Book of Blah and read chapter 13. Either the text is there or not. It may even be squishy, but there. Instead, Anwar posted a refutation document, comprised of multiple blocks of text attempting to make a sequential rationalization. It has six sections: tafsir, what Surah 61:6 means, hadith, that Ahmad is Muhammad, evidence from the Bible, paraclete according to Judaism, theology of the modern-day Holy Spirit, who's the Spirit of Truth. Remember, the challenge is simple. Produce book and chapter and verse where Jesus says the things Muhammad claims he says in Surah 61:6. The concept and mechanism is completely legitimate, as God demonstrated in His Word, the Bible. Prophet Isaiah foretold that God would send a messenger to announce God in the earth. Isaiah 40, verse 3, the voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Prophet Malachi reaffirmed the messenger would announce God as a messenger or prophet would come to his temple. Malachi 3:1, behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. This is God talking. And the Lord whom you seek shall suddenly come to his temple, even the messenger of the covenant, whom you delight in. Behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. Prophet John came saying he was the voice to announce God in the earth coming to his temple. John 1:23, he said, I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Make straight, or prepare, the way of the Lord, as said the prophet Isaiah. And the beauty of this is that if a Muslim were to challenge, where did Isaiah foretell John? We simply answer with, the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, verse 3. And failing to believe us presenting the truth, we simply open the Bible to Isaiah 40, verse 3, and Ikra, read. We read the protected and preserved word of God from Isaiah 40, verse 3. The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. The concept and mechanism is completely legitimate and proves that John's statement is true. The challenge for every Muslim on earth is to prove Muhammad's statement is true. Produce book and chapter and verse directly confirming Muhammad's claim documented in Surah 61:6. But Islam faces an insurmountable problem. They cannot find the text anywhere. Even Didat faced this dilemma and said as much, stating, you must reason with them.
Jesus Christ, according to the Holy Quran, says, وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ says, behold, Jesus, the son of Mary, said, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ O children of Israel, إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ says, most certainly, I am the messenger of God sent to you all. مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاتِ confirming the revelation which came before me. ومصدقا لما بين يدي من التوراة ومبشرا برسول يأتي من بعد اسمه أحمد and giving you glad tidings of a messenger to come after me whose name shall be Ahmad, which is another name for Muhammad. Muhammad and Ahmad are synonymous terms for this mighty messenger of God. Ahmad, that is what the Quran tells us. But the Christian says, look, it's not in my book. It's not here. There's no Ahmad and there's no Muhammad. So you are left with no alternative but to analyze what is there.
That is a tacit admission. There is no text supporting Surah 61:6. If there were any text, you present your evidence. You present book and chapter and verse that proves Surah 61:6. And that means one of two things. Argue that somehow the text was removed, or accept the unacceptable. Surah 61:6 is false, and Muhammad told a lie to create imaginary credentials from the real Word of God. O Muslim, you must decide whether you follow al-Haq, the truth, or one man alone, Muhammad. Let's examine Anwar's document until either you get bored with this video or I get bored correcting errors. My claim, and you have failed completely to show book and chapter and verse which proves Surah 61:6 references an actual statement by Jesus. The burden of proof is on Muhammad and on Mohammedans to prove Muhammad's claim is not a lie. Here is the response in a prepared document, not typed in as part of a discussion with me. Google this phrase and you'll find it comes from the book The Meaning and Explanation of the Glorious Quran, Volume 10. This block of text also comes from the same book. The book is copyright 2009, so only 6 years ago. One might think such a recent book would have the most current information. And yet no mention of book, chapter, and verse where Jesus said what Muhammad claimed he said. Next we come to the section from the Hadiths, or what men said Muhammad said. How admirable the Hadith is that al-Bukhari collected in his Sahih from blah blah blah, who said, I heard the Messenger of Allah say. Just between you and me, I cringe if Muhammad really provided this blasphemous list of I ams. Remember, this is all hearsay and possibly, probably, invention to bolster Muhammad. I have names. I am Muhammad and Ahmad. I have names, darn it. And people skills, no doubt. Muhammad claims he will be the first to be resurrected. I am Al-Hashir, who will be the first to be resurrected, with the people being resurrected hereafter. Which does not supply the book and chapter and verse required by the challenge. So this is offered to prove Surah 61:6 is not a lie? Really, this hadith is offered trying to establish that Muhammad is Ahmad. But I do not think that addresses the real question. My challenge is not prove the Ahmad mentioned in Surah 61:6 is Muhammad by another name. I think that is a diversion and even perhaps a loophole by the author of the Quran. Along the lines of, and his name shall be called Curly or Lionhead. The question is not whether 61:6 talks of Muhammad, because clearly it does, or it speaks of some other person. And if that were the case, it could only refer to another prophet after Muhammad. And that would damn Muhammad's claim as the seal or last prophet of Allah. Remember the trouble keeping a web of lies intact. You are seeing it here in this defense of Muhammad's web. Greetings and felicitations. Also, remember the purpose, the goal. Muhammad claimed Jesus announced Muhammad to establish credentials for Muhammad, not for some future prophet. Also remember the concept and mechanism already demonstrated in this video. Isaiah chapter 40 verse 3 plus Malachi chapter 3 verse 1 plus John chapter 1 verse 23 equals Jesus is God come to earth as a prophet. Look them up. Read them. Ikra. Think what the message of the prophets really means. Prophet Isaiah foretold that God would send a messenger to announce God in the earth. And Prophet Malachi revealed God as a prophet coming to his temple. The concept and mechanism is completely legitimate and proves that John's statement is true. Next, we come to the section titled Evidence from the Bible. Ah, you might think, the perfect place to supply book and chapter and verse. Evidence from the Bible. Let's go through it line by line. In the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 16, chapter 15, verse 26, and chapter 16, verse 7, you should notice only three individual verses are referenced. If you search for the word comforter, you will actually find four uses in the King James Bible. But more than that, the context is larger than these four verses. Here are the four verses. The context of John 14:16 is from John 14 verse 12 through 21. The context of John 14:26 is verse 25 through 29. The context of John 15:26 is John 15:20 through 27. And the context of John 16 verse 7 is verses 1 through 16. Just know that when these three verses are ripped from their context, it is an intellectually bankrupt error. At worst, an intentional deception. The word comforter is used in the English translation for the Greek word parakletos, which means advocate or a kind friend, rather than a comforter. Parakletos is a warped reading for parakletos. One could undertake to examine all the uses of the word comforter. To keep this viewable, let's examine the first. John 14:16 uses Greek word 3875, parakletos. The short definition is an advocate, comforter, helper, paraclete. The long definition is an advocate, intercessor, a counselor, comforter, helper, or a paraclete. Notice, comforter is one of the legitimate meanings. But this author says, means dot 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 rather than, attempting to imply it only means advocate or kind friend. He also excludes intercessor, sloppy and agenda-driven, rather than honestly presenting the truth. Moving on. Jesus actually prophesied AHMAD by name. This is a baseless, unsupportable assertion. Just like Sura 61:6 is baseless and unsupportable, and the cause for the challenge. Now, you might think the next text would provide such support, as if it were possible. Even the Greek word paraclete refers to the prophet who is a mercy for all creatures. A prophet? A mercy for all creatures? What? There is no way to get that nonsense from the actual definitions. Absolutely baseless and unsupported. Where is any evidence? Where is any reference? Any fact? Oblivious to the actual definitions of words, this can only be the work of dun-dun-dun, the purveyor of fantasy and error, Mr. Zakir Naik. Google the text for proof. IRF.com. And what was claimed to be a discussion with Anwar is revealed to be nothing more than a parrot of Zakir Naik's pablum, his ignorant errors. The question for Anwar is, why he repeats logical errors and baseless assertions. It takes but little more time to read and check information than to cut and paste problems. Let's continue with Naik's text, Evidence from the Bible, and see if he ever provides any support for his assertions. Christians say that the Comforter mentioned in these prophecies refers to the Holy Spirit. They fail to realize that the prophecy clearly says that only if Jesus departs will the Comforter come. The Bible states that the Holy Spirit was already present on the earth before and during the time of Jesus. Therefore, Comforter cannot be Gabriel, Holy Spirit. As an aside, Google the whole phrase in pink, and I get 1,850 hits. 1,850 parrot copies, including the misspelling of realize as realize with an S. A few actually fix the spelling of realize with a Z, and you get another 919 results. Too bad they did not fix the factual errors in Naik's block of text when they cut and paste parroted it. This text from Zakir Naik includes a totally destroyed argument, attempting to argue the Holy Spirit Jesus spoke of is not really the Holy Spirit. If you want a full refutation of this failed argument, watch my video, Letter to a Muslim Brother, number 46. The Comforter was already here. The next section ties in another non-Christian source attempting to provide definitions acceptable to Islam's jihad against the Holy Spirit. It is simply and literally irrelevant to the Christian text written in Greek. Then we come to an interesting and peculiar misdirection, again attempting to wage jihad against the Comforter, the Holy Spirit of God. Theology of the Modern Day Holy Spirit? If you want, you can pause and read the whole text. I won't waste the time. Again, let's go through and see if anything is actually correct in this text from Naik. It's okay to judge a source for its accuracy. Does today's Holy Spirit exist anywhere in the Bible? Sure, but only in the book of Acts. The author states only in the book of Acts does the Holy Spirit exist. Would it surprise you that this statement is wrong? The Holy Spirit does not exist anywhere but in the book of Acts? Jude 1:20, but you, beloved, by building yourselves up on your most holy faith and praying in the Holy Spirit. That's one he missed. That's enough to prove him wrong. Ephesians 4:30, and do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God in whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. That's two he missed. Hebrews 9:8, by this arrangement, the Holy Spirit was showing that the way into the most holy place had not yet been disclosed, as long as the first tabernacle was still standing. That's three he missed. 1 Corinthians 16:9, do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. That's four he missed. And yet more trouble for the error that Muhammad is the Holy Spirit, it states, who is in you. 2 Timothy 1:14, guard the good treasure entrusted to you with the help of the Holy Spirit who dwells in us. That's five he missed. And more proof that as Jesus originally stated, the Holy Spirit would be in Christians. The Holy Spirit who dwells in us. Does today's Holy Spirit exist anywhere in the Bible? Sure, but only in the book of Acts. He's wrong, and I have shown with five easily found examples, and the rest of his information is untrustworthy as well. This is a book that is believed to be written by Luke, where Luke contradicted his own gospel, as in chapter 24. Luke indicates that Jesus was on earth for one day after his alleged resurrection. Focus on this one foundational assertion. Luke 24 is a whole chapter. Let's look quickly through Luke 24 and get the gist of it. Luke 24, verse 1, disciples go to the tomb. Verse 2, find stone rolled away. Verse 3, they enter, no body. Verse 4, two men in shiny clothes appear, angels. Verse 5, disciples bow, angels speak. Verse 6, angels say, he is risen. Verse 7, angels remind disciples what Jesus said. Verse 8, the disciples remember. Verse 9, disciples relay events to the 11. Verse 10, it was Mary, Joanna, and other women. Verse 11, the 11 disciples do not believe. Verse 12, Peter went to look for himself. That is it. End of chapter. No mention of one day or Jesus speaking. Read it for yourself. Remember Naik's assertion, his own gospel, as in chapter 24. Luke indicates that Jesus was on the earth for one day. Gee, it takes less than 3 minutes to prove this is false. Is it a mistake or a lie to claim something in this chapter asserts Jesus only came for one day? I think, dear Muslim, you must consider who is teaching provable errors or telling provable lies. The Word of God says what the Word of God says, and men who change it or misrepresent it, like Mr. Zakir Naik, are not to be trusted. If you are Muslim, you must ask if your leaders think you are too lazy or too stupid to catch their lies. I encourage you to watch Anwar and think about the errors and lies you are taught to repeat. If you place any value on the truth, attack Islam's lies the way you chased my mistake with Diotrephes. In fact, I have done all the heavy lifting and explanation for you. You just need to commit to understanding the truth and then accepting it. This last section is even less factual than the previous five. Who's the Spirit of Truth? A clear meaning of the Spirit is given to us from Jesus himself. It asserts the clear meaning is given by Jesus himself, but completely fails to provide what Jesus said in context. John 14:16, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another Comforter, that he may abide with you forever, the Spirit of Truth, whom the world is not able to receive, because it does not see him nor know him. But you know him, for he abides with you, and he will be in you. John 14:16-17 establishes the Comforter is the Spirit of Truth. A spirit, not a prophet. A spirit that is invisible, because the world does not see him. Remember the evidence from the Bible list? The Gospel of John 14:16, 15:26, and 16:7. Remember there were four verses. One was excluded and ignored by Naik. John 14:26. Let's see what it says, because it damns this whole subterfuge of the last section. John 14:26. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, Spirit, Pneuma, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Wait, what? But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, or Holy Spirit, the Pneuma, Hagion. That clearly states in black and white terms, or yellow and blue in this case, who Jesus revealed as the Comforter. All other fabrications and inventions to somehow twist and torture what Jesus said is just dissimulation and deception by Satan's minions. Since Jesus says the words he spoke are spirit and God's word is the truth, could Jesus have meant that the Spirit of Truth is the Word of God? Amazingly, Jesus has foretold the coming of words and wisdom with no contradictions. This last text is naught but conflated gibberish. Jesus says his words are two things, spirit and life. John 6:63, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Since Jesus says the words he spoke are spirit and God's word is the truth, could Jesus have meant that the spirit of truth is the word of God? Actually, no, in this context. However, in the context of the Trinity, there is a deep spiritual truth that may declare yes, but that is the topic for another video, and certainly not what Mr. Naik is attempting to claim. Amazingly, Jesus has foretold the coming of words and wisdom with no contradictions. Again, what? This last sentence is another non sequitur attempting to create an imaginary link to the Quran's self-supporting claim of having no contradictions. So this sentence is worthless garbage for multiple reasons. Thank you for caring enough about the truth to watch this to the end. Once again, Islam demonstrates it cannot support Surah 61:6 as based on any real text. Do I really need to tell you what that proves about Muhammad's claims? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.